Hello and welcome to the beautiful Sunshine Coast, our second stop for the Ocean 6 series for 2017-2018. Queensland's beautiful Sunshine Coast will play host to the best surf sports athletes in the world in one of the most naturally refreshing locations anywhere in the world. Joining me in commentary, as always, is former professional Ironman Jack Hansen. Jack, it's good to be on the Sunshine Coast, and we've got an absolutely incredible lineup of events today.
Josh, it's a huge day of racing. Going to be super exciting, a format we've never seen before, and it's really going to test the athletes out there today.
Just the Nutrigrain Iron Women's Series and the Nutrigrain Iron Man Series. We'll have race one of the girls, race one of the guys, and then we'll come back with the top 10. Both doing the M-shape eliminator format. We'll explain that a little bit later on, but let's take a look at the round one highlights. And they come from all across the country, and they've arrived here to board, swim, and ski their way to Iron Woman glory. Here we go, off and away. Carly Nerthen and Kirsty Higgison, their former training partners. I didn't think they'd got down it, but it picks up and out the back. It's dial a wave time. Everyone's on one. And it's a party wave on the next one. They're all down at 2, 4, 6, 8. Well, they're all off it as well. We see them streaming out the back. Gemma Smith there, Maddie Dunn. But it's not enough because Georgia Miller's done a Houdini act of her own and popped up out of nowhere. She's going to push down it. Can Smith go with her? Miller's down it. This could be the decisive moment in the race. Miller's resting. Smith's going with her. I think Smith's down it as well. So Miller and Smith side by side. We're going to have a sprint finish for round one. What more could you want? Smith's off first. Miller's half a step behind. I don't think she's going to get her. The Young Gun's going to get it. They'll celebrate in your minor tonight. A big win. The Nutrigrain Iron Woman Series round one to Gemma Smith. She crosses the line for the biggest moment of her career. Well, Gemma Smith from Umina announced her arrival in the Nutrigrain Iron Woman Series in round one over Georgia Miller and Lizzie Wellborn. A couple of the big names were expecting to be further up, like Courtney Hancock and Harriet Brown, just snuck inside the top 10. And, well, Carly Nerthen was the hard luck story of round one, Jack, wasn't she? She led early and she got absolutely belted. Coolum Beach plays host to round two. It's got a reputation for chaos and carnage, and today will be no different. The surf is on. We've got 6 to 8 foot of swell and a lot of wind. Jack, talk us through the M-shape eliminator.
Starting with 20 athletes, Josh. Every time they hit the beach from the first swim leg, we will eliminate two athletes. The top 10 go through to the final, and we repeat the process once again.
We'll do it all again to try and find ourselves Nutrigrain Iron Woman round two champion here. There's some very special athletes lining up today, Jack, and there's a couple to watch. Obviously, the round one winner, Gemma Smith, will be looking to repeat the dose.
Well, Gemma Smith is on fire. She's a young gun, an under-19 competitor. We saw her dust Georgia Miller up in round one. Will she be able to do it again in these testing conditions at Coolum?
Second place, Georgia Miller there. She'll be looking to go one better. Showed absolute class last year and really put in a couple of good performances with a round win. She'll be chasing another one here today. And she's certainly one to watch early on in the swim leg.
Next up is Lizzie Wellborn, third place getter in round one, Josh. She is a board paddling superstar. Keep an eye on her early on. Also has good form in the M-shape format, so should be one to keep an eye on.
Was our round one winner last summer, and we'll look to do it again. And of course, the queen of surf life saving and Iron Woman racing, Courtney Hancock. Endurance racing certainly is right up her alley. Had a little bit of bad luck at Queenscliff and will be looking to bounce back here today. She's a three-time series champion in the past and wants to make it four in 2017-2018.
Then we have Harriet Brown, our world champion, current Nutrigrain Ironwoman champion and the one to beat. She will be looking to recapture the form from 2016-17 and carry that over into this season.
They are the ones to watch here, but there's plenty of girls trying to knock them off the pedestal. An interesting start list. It's either experience or young guns, and have a look at that. A couple of the names there we haven't seen before. Electra Outram got her first start last round. Carla Papax, another one of the young guns, former Australian junior champion. Matty Spencer and Bay Wilton-Sneddon, very inexperienced, but they get their shot right here, right now at Coolum. Off and away. The order is swim, ski, board. Key is stay out of the bottom two. You can't win it in this first race, but you can certainly lose it. The girls are in and away. Jack, as a coach, what would you be saying to your athletes heading into an interesting race like this and a format none of these girls have seen before?
Well, you need to set this event up from the very beginning. The first swim leg is critical. The first leg of the M shape is critical. Working through this 4+ foot break, which is slamming down on the Coolum bank, is going to be very tricky. Whoever can set this race up, whoever can get themselves a good start, will put themselves in a good position to make sure they're not in the bottom two.
And it seems like luck could play a massive role in a day like today, but in the past when we've come to Coolum, the big names have shone through. The likes of Shannon Eckstein, Hugh Doherty, Matt Poole, Courtney Hancock, they've really stood up here. Is it about luck or is it about skill?
Well, Josh, it all comes down to skill. Here at Coolum, as we said, there are some large swells breaking out the back, and with the break being quite long, they're going to have to negotiate a large number of waves each time they're trying to get themselves to the back of the break. That is going to come back to skill. Making the right decisions, getting your skills right, and eliminating all mistakes is going to be crucial here at Coolum.
And of course, stay out of the red zone. That's the bottom two every time they hit the sand, except for this first time. So it's not about winning today, but you can certainly set yourself up and make it a whole lot easier if you're in the front end and you just don't want to be at the back. And it makes it tough for a couple of the girls whose swim probably isn't the strongest and will be hoping to sort of work their way through the field as this M shape gets further and further in. And well, how do you manage that? Obviously, you've got to go hard from the start.
Well, to explain the M shape a little bit further, Josh, because it may be slightly confusing for those at home, instead of our normal traditional square shape, the girls will go around a can at the back of the break and make their way straight back to the beach before turning a can on the beach and heading straight back out to do it all again.
And it makes it easier if you get a wave. A number of the front markers have got waves here, and I think this will turn it on its head. A couple of the girls bobbing straight underneath that white water, so I don't know what the plan was there, but interesting tactics from the girls. You'd think most of them would be trying to ride this white water in, and a couple of them just bobbing around like tea bags. So that's not what you want to see out there in the ocean at the moment. And it is a couple of our big guns on the front end of this. The Northcliffe cap, white with the maroon star. Maddie Dunn is definitely there. Lana Rogers stands up and gets waiting as well. Courtney Hancock's in the mix, and it looks like the Currawa cap. And if I had to hazard a guess, I'd definitely say it was Rebecca Creedy, the former Commonwealth Games gold medalist in swimming.
Well, Josh, forget Rebecca Creedy. That's Brielle Cooper, the young gun from the same club as Rebecca, the Currawa Surf Club on the Gold Coast, and she is pushing the pace and feeding it to the big guns.
Oh, isn't she ever? An unbelievable performance as we see the girls make their way through the elimination point, but we won't lose any now. The next time they hit the beach, only 18 will survive. Maddie Dunn rolls through, Carly Nerthen as well, Lizzie Wellborn and Gemma Smith. They were in the top three last round with Jordy Mercer, Carla Papak, Electra Outram, and Georgia Miller. They're a long way back. This is where things start to get interesting. 18, 19, and 20. These girls are in trouble. Danielle McKenzie, Lily Costello, and Maddie Spencer. They need to get a wriggle on in this second swim if they want to survive and keep their chances of claiming a Nutrigrain Iron Woman Series round alive.
Well, at this stage, if the race was to stop where it is, Costello and Spencer would be gone. They would be cut. They need to make sure they do the work to get themselves into at least 17th position to make sure they're not out after this first M-shaped leg.
And we'll keep an eye on that the entire way through. The girls make their way out to the blue and white smaller swim cans. The board will be around the black and red. The ski will be around the orange in the far distance. And it's going to make for a very, very long race today because Coolum certainly turned on the swell, and it doesn't look like it at the moment, but it's a bit of a sleeping giant because when Coolum really wants to throw down some swell, it can create carnage.
Well, it's not only the waves that are making for the tricky conditions out here at Coolum. The sweep is running to the north, which is also making it extremely tricky for these girls. What we've seen them do in this first swim, or second part of this first M, is head south, run south, and make sure they swim themselves back onto that can and don't miss it fighting against the sweep.
Well, that's how big it is. A couple of the girls pushing down waves as they turn the can. Gemma Smith rounds and has a lot of work to do in front of Bay Wilden-Sneddon there. Tian Raymond as well, and Lizzie Wellborn, who's at the back of the pack. Georgia Miller swum her way into a solid position. Carla Papak and Jordan Mercer are in trouble. They're right on the edge and living dangerously.
Well, Josh, you need to make sure you're up as high as possible, particularly in the conditions like it is today. If a wave comes through for the back markers, you are going to have no idea where you are and could very well be in the bottom too.
What about Brielle Cooper? This has been a very, very good early swim from her. We saw her in the heats earlier on. Have good swims, but then battle a bit and get her way through. Her best performance so far in a Nutrigrain Ironwoman Series race has been 14th, and now she finds herself leading very early on, but there's also two legs and then another race to go, so she doesn't want to get too ahead of herself at the moment as she makes her way through very comfortably. Brielle Cooper from the Currawa Club there, and the rest of the girls out the back, we can see at the bottom, they're waiting for a wave. One's cleaned them up. I don't know about that. They're getting thrown around like rag dolls. None of them have been able to pick up that wave, and they're some of the best surf skills competitors in the world, and they're not able to pick up this white water.
Well, while some of these girls are still out the back of the break, Brielle Cooper goes round, making her way through the first transition and about to pick up her ski and make her way to the back of the break. If she can get it right here, she is going to open up and continue to open up an even bigger gap, which will put her well out of trouble and well out of the red zone.
This is where things start to get interesting. It's the fastest craft. That means you can make up or lose the most time. Courtney Hancock, no dramas. Harriet Brown, Emma Dick had a great swim as well. Tian Raymond flew through there. There's Rebecca Creedy chasing her teammate. Lana Rogers doing well from the Noosa Club, and Carly Nerthen is a little bit further back than she was in the first round, but she's hoping for some more luck. And have a look at the girls on the right-hand side still making their way in. So we're chasing the top 18 will survive after this leg. Gemma Smith, she's sitting further back than she wants to, but she is okay at the moment. Bay Wilden-Sneddon, this has been a great weekend for her to get herself up and race with the big guns. And the move to the Currawa Club's obviously paying off, Jack.
Well, her first opportunity to race in the Nutrigrain Ironwoman Series, currently sitting in 11th place. She needs to make sure she keeps pushing that pace along to keep her out of the red zone.
Lizzie Wellborn's had the cap ripped off by the surf. Ali Britton will just get better as this race goes on, and she'll enjoy the long transition, but this is where things start to get serious. Maddie Spencer's through. Jordan Mercer survives. Georgia Miller does. Danielle McKenzie and Electra Outram. Carla Papert goes home. She's been called out of the race, finished in the bottom two, and that means Lily Costello from the Redhead Club will not continue in this race. And Jack, just like that, your race can be over after one leg.
Well, the move was from Maddie Spencer. She went from 19th place up into 15th. She made sure she wasn't in the bottom two. She gave herself every opportunity to stay in this race and stay in the point score.
Well, the drama's just beginning here at Coolum. Stick with us. We'll be back with the Nutrigrain Ironwoman Series. Welcome back to Ocean 6 and the Nutrigrain Ironwoman Series, and Coolum Beach is coming to life. The girls are heading out in the second leg of the Ironwoman race, and well, they're in for a tough time here, Jack. The swell's on, Gemma Smith's out, and they are certainly doing it tough negotiating this break.
Well, Josh, the hardest part in Ironwoman racing, getting your ski to the back of the break, but then it's not over. You've got to get your ski back in. And Courtney Hancock has been absolutely belted on the break here at Coolum.
Bay Wilden-Sneddon's going backwards at a rate of knots. Turn it around, Bay. You don't want to go that way, as the rest of the girls are doing their best. Have a look at the look of fear on Lizzie Wellborn as she gets absolutely swallowed by a Coolum crash set.
Well, it is chaos here at Coolum in this ski leg. Girls are upside down and back to front as Jordan Mercer crashes over the top of one. Can she get herself to the back of the break? Will she be the only one to get out?
She manages to stay upright. Lizzie Wellborn's had an extra swim leg. You don't want that. And what about the look of fear in her eyes as that one came towards her? She knows she's heading towards the red zone here, our bottom two. So 17th and 18th place, they will end when they get back to the beach, as our leaders, they seem to be cruising on the way home. And just like that, it's either agony or ecstasy out here in the Ironwoman Series, because our leaders are loving it and our backmarkers are hating it.
Well, Josh, as they were coming back in, Mercer now still on her way out has come off again. So she's still trying to negotiate this break here at Coolum, whereas Rebecca Creedy, who is currently our leader, was making her way back to the beach out in front.
It's all Currawa at the moment. And Jordan Mercer's one of our most skilled iron women when it comes to surf, and she is swimming and spending half of her time trying to climb back on the ski as Lizzie Wellborn cops another one. She rides it like a cowboy and then gets flipped off. No thank you. Sometimes you just can't hang on. on, and Lizzie Wellborn wouldn't. Oh, as another one comes through there. So shades of Mitch Miller in Perth from a couple of years ago when she can do nothing wrong. And have a look, she's forced to roll again, relentless here. That's three sets in a row on the head. Rebecca Creedy has no dramas at all and is making it look very easy in one. Harriet Brown in two. Brielle Cooper and Emma Dick in three and four. So they are sitting pretty on top of our leaderboard at the moment. And as the girls make their way through, remember, 17th and 18th place will go home. Carly Nerthen from the Currumbin Club has no dramas at all, getting a little bit more luck than round one. Maddie Dunn there, she's through as well. So the girls will make their way out. We'll drop two at the moment and head in. You want to finish in the top 10 from this initial M-shaped Iron Woman race to make it through to the final, where we will decide our round winner. Lana Rogers from just up the road at Noosa. You can almost see Noosa in the background when we look to the left-hand side of the screen there. So she knows the conditions well. Oh, just catches her ski on the turning flag there. And that is our top seven. We need nine more to go through, and here they come. The girls are on. Georgia Miller, no dramas at all. Bay Wilden-Sneddon, one of her very first races using the ski in the Ironwoman, has mastered it like a true champion.
Well, Miller had a little bit of trouble negotiating the small short break there. Gemma Smith currently in 13th place. Josh still has plenty of work to do, and mistakes like that could easily put you outside the top 16 and into the red zone.
Well, that is not what you want. Jordan Mercer's managed to get back on and around. Round through comes Tian Raymond. Oh, sorry, Ali Britton there, the clubmates at the Burley Heads Mowbray Park Club. So Danielle McKenzie, Gemma Smith, and Jordan Mercer, they are all safe, but not for long. They're gonna have to get a wriggle on. And what about this? Third in round one, still only just going around the turning can. 14th, Electra Outram, another one of the young guns, just an under 17. And a couple of our girls are getting absolutely belted on the way back out. Maddie Dunn is off the side and swimming. It looks like Carly Nerthen's had a little bit of trouble, but out in front without a drama in the world from Burley Heads is Emma Dick, who's made a massive comeback after having chronic fatigue, well, only one season ago. Oh, Maddie Spencer goes off on the right-hand side, so maybe that's opened the door. No, it hasn't for Lizzie Wellborn, and upsets already. These two will be the final two through as they head around. Courtney Hancock survives, Tian Raymond survives, and just like that, we say goodbye to Lizzie Wellborn and Maddie Spencer, and a bit of a Coolum curse there for a couple of the girls. Well, one of the favourites for the overall series. She's going to have to sit back, relax, and watch the rest of this race unfold and not take part.
Well, that's not going to be easy to do for Lizzie Wellborn, nor will it be for Maddie Spencer. No one likes sitting back, not being involved in the racing. And Jordan Mercer currently making her way out into that second ski leg now of the M shape. Is really getting belted through this break.
Oh, absolutely smashed. That hits with the force of an absolute freight train there. Mercer's off, and you can see the frantic nature. Has to roll again, get it straight, point it out to sea, get back on and get going. And these girls, have a look at there. Have a look. She's facing the wrong way. Jordan Mercer's facing into the beach while Gemma Smith and the rest of the field are paddling out to sea. And this could prove absolutely catastrophic for our former Iron Woman Series champion, Jordan Mercer.
Well, Josh, these positions are changing extremely quickly. Emma Dick, she wasn't up the front, but she managed to negotiate the break on her ski and get past Rebecca Creedy and Brielle Cooper to put herself out in front. Jordan Mercer in 15th place. She's in the cutoff zone at the moment. Top 14 will stay on. Jordan Mercer sitting in 15th will be cut if she doesn't get herself back to the beach quick enough.
Only 14 girls will be allowed to do the board leg, so Carly Nerthen makes her way through. Brielle Cooper has been an absolute standout so far. Watch out for her in the future. Training with the likes of Maddie Poole and Matt Bevilacqua down there, and of course Rebecca Creedy down there at the Currawa Club. She's had an absolutely stellar start. The complete opposite end of the spectrum. Gemma Smith's had to battle the whole way through. Rebecca Creedy's through. Maddie Dunn's through. Lana Rogers is through. And it's only 14 girls that will continue past into the board leg, and well, the former world board champion in Harriet Brown will be looking forward to this one, as will Maddie Dunn. I don't know about Rebecca Creedy, not the best board paddler. She'll just have to survive.
Well, take note of these girls up the front end. They're relaxed, they're comfortable, they can concentrate on their breathing and go through the process. Then we flick to Gemma Smith. Have a look at her. She's in trouble. She's making mistakes. She's panicking. And so are all the girls who are currently outside the top 10, because they know if they're not in the top 10 at the end of this this race, they're out of the final.
Oh, they look around. Jordan Mercer stops and have a look at Gemma Smith ski. We can see her swimming for it, trying to get back to it there. This could prove deadly for our round one winner. Danielle McKenzie, she is through in eighth place and we're only chasing six more. So Jordan Mercer gets a nice little wave. But oh, just as I say it, the commentator's curse, she goes off. And this is unbelievable. Some of the best in the business have been reduced to absolute nipper status while they chase their craft into the beach.
Well, Georgia Miller goes through there. She's in a comfortable position in ninth place. And Danielle McKenzie goes into one of her favoured legs. She's a craft competitor. She's going to look to keep making her move forward, as she has so far through the M-shaped course.
Bay Wildenstedden survives. Ali Britton as well. She's grinding into this one very, very nicely. So 11 around. We're chasing three more names to survive to the board race. It's no guarantee that they're going to get to the final. Electra Outram's through. She's doing very well. Jordan Mercer, will she get through? Will she get off? She's up and away, and it looks like she may just survive. May just survive this one and get to go onto the board leg as the girls start to make their way out on the craft at the moment. Sit up, pop through it, and do your best when the next one comes. And it's all about board speed. So we've got 13 of 14 girls there. Who will get the final place as they come round? A couple of the big names have already gone home. And Gemma Smith, our round one winner, she beats Tian Raymond up the beach. She survives, and we say goodbye to the Burley Heads Mowbray Park. Tian Raymond there, she goes home, as well as it looks like Courtney Hancock. So she was swimming early on. She will not compete in the rest of this, and the queen of Iron Woman Racing has to sit it out.
Well, the eliminations are coming thick and fast, and at this stage, it's the young guns who are making a huge play to keep themselves in this race. Forget about Generation Next. This is Generation Now, and it's being led by the likes of Brielle Cooper, Gemma Smith, and Georgia Miller, who are all still racing and making sure they're going to be in that final.
But will they survive in the top 10? Carly Nerthen's found a nice little wave, as has Rebecca Creedy, Brielle Cooper and Harriet Brown, Maddie Dunn as well. These girls will be feeling very comfortable as they make their way through. They'll get a rest after this initial race. And you can see out the back, that's the race just to survive. Gemma Smith and Jordan Mercer are still going out in 13th and 14th place. And only the top 12 will get a start in the final part of this Iron Woman Round 2 competition. Rebecca Creedy, no dramas at all, pops up. So we've got one through. Carly Nerthen, Creedy and Cooper from Currawa. They'll go through in 2 and 3. Harriet Brown, she's reasonably safe, but just like anything, it can be turned on its head if Coolum decides it's not your day. Emma Dick, Maddie Dunn, they are sitting pretty in 4 and 5 through the elimination point. Top 12 will survive top 10 at the finish line. Rebecca Creedy seems very happy at the moment. A picture of concentration and no real dramas. Harriet Brown from Northcliffe as well. She ducks under the flag inside the top 6. And, well, this is where we start to feel a little bit stressed for a couple of these competitors. Lana Rogers, no problems at all. Maddie Dunn's been forced to climb back on. And it looks like these girls are tired, but they have to do it all again and race for the title, Jack.
Well, what's extremely interesting to note, Josh, is how much the positions are changing. We have had almost a different leader in every leg. Carly Nerthen has gone to the front now. Harriet Brown starts to make her way out to negotiate the break for the last time in this M-shape Iron Woman event until the final. And Lana Rogers has made her way back through.
Danielle McKenzie makes her way in. She'll survive. You know what's great about this race is that it gives you time to work your way through the field, but you can't be in the last two. It's long enough that if you're one of the endurance athletes, you've got time to get there. You just can't be in the bottom two. Otherwise, it's good night, goodbye, and thank you very much. Bay Wildenstedden, she will survive in ninth place, and here we go. This is where things start to get super interesting as the girls make their way around. So Wildenstedden in 9, Electra Outram in 10, Ali Britton in 11, and she thinks she's out, but no, she's still in this one. So Britton thought she was gone, but she's going to have to get going again because we're taking 12 through. The sprint up the beach, down the bottom, and Georgia Miller survives, and our round one winner will go home. And just like that, Gemma Smith gets eliminated and Jordan Mercer goes home as well. So dramatic stuff here on the finish line. Ali Britton thought she was gone. Our round one winner goes home and the 2015-2016 Nutrigrain Iron Woman Series champion will be forced to watch the final from the grandstand.
Well, Ali Britton still managing to hang hang on by the skin of her teeth as our leader out in front, Carly Nerthen, comes down a bomb set. She's going to make sure she's through to the final. She's going to carry herself a place and give herself a shot at the title here at Coolum.
Do you think some of them just wanted to give up? They thought they were out because they have been battered and bruised here. It wouldn't surprise me if a few of them have thrown up the white flag and said, please eliminate me, because it is tough racing as we see Georgia Miller cop an absolute hiding at the bottom of the screen. And on the far right-hand side, up and over goes Ali Britton there. So tough stuff for these two backmarkers. They're just trying to survive. You finish in the top 10 here, you get yourself a spot in the final, and Ali Britton gets absolutely pumped again. It's two steps forward, one step back at the moment for these two as Miller goes up and over, and our leaders, Brielle Cooper, Emma Dick, and Maddie Dunn, Carly Nerthen, they're making their way up the beach and home. A quick high five from Geordie Mercer. Good sportsmanship there. She's supporting the girls as they're going up and around, and we'll have these two in our final.
Well, Carly Nerthen goes through. Joining her will be Rebecca Creedy as well. So they're safe. They're ready to relax, get their breath back, and make sure they're prepared for this final race. They will have to rest up because they have to do it all again, Josh.
And just like that, Harriet Brown and Brielle Cooper, they've done it reasonably easy. And have a look at the bottom of our screen there. Ali Britton continues to get absolutely smashed. Emma Dick is through. Maddie Dunn is through as well. So we've got six heading up the beach and a couple more getting waves on the outside. Just like that, Electra Outram gets an absolute flyer. And that will almost, well, maybe will it get her into this race? Because there's a couple of girls still making their way out to sea. Georgia Miller's got a wave. Harriet Brown and Brielle Cooper, they're in. No worries at all. Just like that, five and six. Have a look out the back, trying to get waves, but I think it's too little too late for Georgia Miller. Up and through Lana Rogers in seven. So we've got three more spots. Who will get in our final? Electra Outram will make it two in the top 10. She'll finish in eighth place, and a great job. She's only under 17, Jack. That's an incredible, incredible performance. Danielle McKenzie, she did it tough, but she survived in nine. And Bay Wilden Sneddon, what about that? So the young guns continue to push their claim here in the Nutri-Grain Iron Woman Series. So McKenzie will get nine, Wilden Sneddon will get 10, and we'll say goodbye to Georgia Miller and Ali Britton. And just like that, our podium from round one goes home.
Well, Josh, a huge day of racing, and there's Georgia Miller making her way up for the last time. She knows she's outside the top 10. She knows she's out of the final. Disappointment, but a valiant effort to get through the conditions here at Coolum.
Sometimes Mother Nature just says it's not your day, and today wasn't Georgia Miller's, that's for sure. We wait on Ali Britton, who's still making her way in, and, well, you can't say it was unlucky, but geez, she got pounded by the Coolum conditions. She absolutely got hammered on the way out. Now racing for the Burley Heads Mowbray Park Club under the guidance of former professional Ironman Wes Berg. She will not be in our top 10, but these girls will be. Nerthen and Creedy, they were good to get through to the final like they did. Danielle McKenzie and Bay Wilden Sneddon just survived. But the big news is the ones who won't be there. Georgia Miller, Gemma Smith, Jordan Mercer and Lizzie Wellborn, four girls who you'd have to say were the favourites. They will sit on the sidelines. Coming up, it's the men's turn. This is the Nutri-Grain Ironman and Ironwoman Series.